All right, joining us right now is Sara Azari. She's an attorney, and you're very interested in all of this. Now, I want to ask you a question. We don't know what she told authorities. Mm-hmm. The FBI isn't going to come out immediately and say this is what she said. But if you were her attorney at this point, what would you be cautioning her about?
Well, I would try to find out exactly what she knows and then limit the scope of the interview to things that I don't think would incriminate her. I mean, I thought her statement through her lawyer was very genuine. I think she's clueless. I think she's going to have information, or perhaps she already gave this information, about who Paddock was, who he associated with, whether she knew about the amassing of these guns over the course of a year. I mean, how could you live with someone and not know that they're buying all these guns and bringing them into the house? Where he was storing them, what he was doing with them, what was his explanation for having all these guns?
Did she really know that he had all those guns?
Yes, I don't know what she has said about her knowledge of the guns. I would have a hard time believing that you live with somebody in a home, unless he was storing them somewhere else. Mm-hmm. But if he was actually bringing in these guns to the residence that he shared with her, I think it would be very difficult to believe that she had no knowledge that these guns were in the house.
So she is a critical witness into finding out why he did this, but does she have to speak?
She doesn't, and I think the fact that her attorney did not invoke her Fifth Amendment right to remain silent is because they clearly said she's a person of interest. That just means that they're interested in speaking to her. She could be a witness. She could be nothing.
That phrase, by the way, is misunderstood, and that phrase came along when people, mm-hmm. police would say, so-and-so is under suspicion. When they weren't under suspicion, they just
right.
wanted to talk to them.
And that's very different from a suspect.
Yes.
You can turn into a suspect mm-hmm. and start off as being a person of interest, or you can just become a witness.
All right. What we know of this story is that suddenly he got her a plane ticket, mm-hmm. according to what she told people.
A few weeks before.
Yeah, 2 weeks.
Got her a plane ticket. Mm-hmm. She went back home to the Philippines. Then sent her a bunch of money. And she thought that money was for her family to buy a house in the mm-hmm. Philippines, but she also thought it was his way of breaking up with mm-hmm. her.
It's like he shipped her off, gave her a bunch of money, which in the Philippines, that's a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
You can buy a house and then some, you know. And I think that to her it was a little odd that he would do this. But again, when you put this in the context of who this woman was, she has family in the Philippines, she would travel regularly, she has family in Australia. So it's not unusual, that unusual for her to be traveling. The money, I think initially law enforcement thought it's hush money, and I think that she had a very credible explanation that this, at least what he told her, she believed.
Did she have to release her phone records?
I think she's cooperating and she will, but they can easily get those through a subpoena. And I think they're going to look at everybody that this guy knew, that he associated with. Unfortunately, it seems like from the neighbors that they were very, very much recluses.
He put up a fence around his place.
Yes.
She was friendlier than he was friendly.
Yeah.
And remember, this guy is 6 foot 4 inches tall. He stood mm-hmm. out in the crowd, but he apparently was a very quiet guy. As an attorney, mm-hmm. we've talked about this in the past. Sometimes the role of an attorney is to get in the way of truth and not bring truth mm-hmm. out. What fine line do you work here? Because there's national interest in this.
Well, I think that, you know, I actually know her lawyer, and I believe that this was a credible account of what she knows, which is hardly
anything.
So
she's not holding back.
I don't think she's holding anything back.
Well, she flew back.
She
flew back
voluntarily.
That's a big deal.
Yes, yes. And I think ultimately she's going to help them with leads that they then need to do further investigation.
Well, she would be the key. She would know more than anybody else, you would think.
His brother certainly doesn't know much.
Difficult for you to say, but what's the outcome here with her? What do you think?
You know, I don't think she's going to have any exposure. I think at best she might be a witness, but I think she's more of someone who's going to facilitate this investigation and lead law enforcement and the FBI to other leads and mm-hmm. other people that could possibly explain this. I mean, the nation needs answers. These victims and their families need answers. This was a horrible, heinous act.
I
just...
It pains us in this tragedy not to have answers.
So. Absolutely.
Sara Azari, thank you so much
for
being with
me.
Us.
Thank you.
Coming up